greasy?
Auntie greeting, potential customer. Welcome to Auntie's Kitchen, a home-style consumable protein dispensary. May this unit dispense proteins for your ingestion.
Aren't you just a glorified vending machine?
This unit is programmed to simulate shock at such assertions. Shock simulation non-functional.
Oh.
A trouble ticket has been filed.
Shock simulation. Let me take a look at that. Maybe I can fix it.
Shock simulation restored. Initiating shock subroutine. How dare you? Shock subroutine complete. Estimated guilt level of customer increased by 35%. Resuming protein dispensation protocol. May this unit dispense proteins for your ingestion.
Glad to help. Let's see what you've got.
Beginning dispensing sequence. Please unblock all relevant facial protein ingestion tubes.
I don't want you to stuff it right in my mouth. Chef hat. Ports of call. Two-handed melee plus 5 somehow. Our chef hat is designed to give any chef a place to tuck in their hair, no matter how much they have. Also for use on automechanicals who don't have hair. Lightweight headgear for work. It's really suspenseful music for a chef hat. Yeah, nothing today. Thanks, though.
Have you seen this man? Reward offered for information leading to the capture of noted terrorist Phineas Wells. Report any sightings to your local board embassy.
They're really looking for you, Wells. Well, the board is, anyway. There's a dead person back there. Anti-Cleo worker. Anti-Cleo food service, automechanical. Repair manual. Maintenance and repair. Warning, please follow all recommended safety protocols before maintaining or cleaning your unit. The ACSRF-900 is equipped with anti-tampering subsystems which trigger a self-defense mechanism in the food preparation apparatus. Self-defense supersedes any pacifistic function. Oh, well, that was his error. Please also remember to deactivate and remove all slicing, dicing, blending, filleting, chopping, deboning, or tenderizing apparatus prior to opening any access panels. It is critical that... And then a spray of blood is obscuring the rest of the manual. Well, now we know what happened to him. Wonderful.
Have you seen this man? Reward offered for information leading to the capture of noted terrorist Phineas Wells. Report any sightings to your local board embassy. Have you seen this man?
Okay.
Reward offered for information leading to the capture of noted terrorist Phineas Wells. Go back to Byzantium, you gold-plated bastards. Report any sightings.
Yeah, no one wants you on Groundbreaker.
These stairs are board property. Disperse now, or I'll detain you for trespassing.
Oh,
okay. Oh, real scary. You're really gonna arrest us on our station?
Yeah, this is Chief Junling's ship. You don't own shit here.
Step back! I'm required by board bylaws to use excessive force.
The Mardets would space you for trying, you waste of O2 scrubbers.
Yeah, O2 scrubbers.
Look, just get out of here before I tell your captain what you've been getting up to on the clock.
Ah, whatever. We got a date at the Lost Hope anyway.
That worked.
Is this really what you want to be doing with your life, Marcy? Guarding stairs for that walking mustache Udom fucking Bedford? I gotta get off this detail.
I can't can't believe the board allows an unaffiliated station like this to stay open.
I think it's kind of a challenge for them.
Huh?
I'd say it's a challenge for them.
This heat's unbearable.
Don't look funny at the crew. Heard they toss folks out the airlock if they don't like your face.
Before I go visit, Udom, I think is his name? Udom, let's check at this terminal. Let's check the public notices first, if there's anything different. Regarding the food situation. To those of you who have raised concerns about the quality of Groundbreaker's victuals, yes, I'm aware that the promenade stinks. Allow me to put the matter to rest. Our ancestors didn't rise up from humble beginnings on a diet of spratwurst and borst, but that's the reality of life up here. If you can salt it, can it, or zip it up in a pouch, then we're not picky about calling it food. Spacers make do with what they have, and what we have is smelly meat, lots of salt, and 11 kinds of mustard. Last time I counted. Try and enjoy it. JT. Ship impounded? Question mark? This is a general notice about our impound policies. If the board impounded your ship, take it up with the board. Their embassy is the Gaudy building opposite Sublight's warehouse. Yes, or just past it. Send them your questions, outstanding fees, and hate mail. Especially hate mail. If Groundbreaker impounded you, pay your damn fees and don't bother my people. Looking for work. Urgently looking for a new crew to sign on with. I've been stuck in Halcyon for almost a year now. Don't know what's holding up my next posting. Never had to wait this long to get on another freighter. I'm planning to take one of those rare long hauls back to Earth, but I haven't been able to find any, and even the shorter skips to the inner worlds seems rarer than the outer world routes these days. If anyone has any information about upcoming work, please post it here. Down on my luck. Hey, so here's my story. My ship limped into Groundbreaker in a rough state. We couldn't make the repair fees, docking fees, refueling, or the fees for not being able to pay our fees, so I'm kind of stuck here now. Then they took my ship and sold it off as scrap. Now my credit is shot to hell and corporate freighters won't hire me on. I'm hoping for someone with a bunk to spare and places to go is feeling charitable. Thanks for listening. This notice has been posted 56 times in 632 days. That's almost 2 years. Alright. Return. Let's hack into the messages admin access. Recent messages. Welcome, administrator. Two Wildcat groups subject Groundbreaker meetup. From Kitty Buchanan? I'm saying that right? Even though it's been nigh on 20 years since our last meeting on Groundbreaker, I was hoping we could get the old gang back together. I understand that things have changed. Some of us are long-range haulers, some of us have gone corporate, some of us are likely dead, and some of us are on Tartarus and not reading this message, but I haven't lost hope. No one responded to my last invite. I hope that means your schedules are full up with family gatherings and job opportunities. To IS Conveyors Collective, Subject Conveyors Rights. From Iceman. Hi all, I just got off ice from a ground trip to Dashkova. 2 years out, 2 years back. Imagine my surprise when we de-thawed and Groundbreaker comms told us our docking was going to be delayed. 1 hour turned into 5, then days went by. In the end, we spent an entire goddamn week waiting for a berth on this law... bolt bucket. And because we were kicking our heels all that time, not a one of us got paid. I don't know about you, but I got expenses. Family I don't see often enough. Debt you wouldn't believe. And even if I'm not working, I still gotta make my payments. Does that seem proper to you? Don't we conveyors have rights? We should do something about this. If you agree, leave a message here. I'll respond when I get back from Gensan. In 3 years. Iceman out. This message is no longer accessible at your clearance level. Conveyor's rights. Your attempt to access this message has been logged. Searching. This message does not exist. Stop looking or else. Message contents empty. Sure it is. All right. Alright, let's talk to this guy. Udom?
Ah, the board. Organized, efficient, competent. Well, mostly.
I think everything in here is worth more than I made in my whole life.
Some townships have asked Halcyon News to make a statement.
Where are we headed?
Oh.
I could spend hours reflecting on the secret workings of the universe. So, tell me what's on your mind.
Hello.
Ah, yes. Wheeler messaged me you were coming. You must be the captain of the Unreliable, a vessel that used to be helmed by one Alex Hawthorne. And you are not he.
Correct.
Has something happened to my favorite scruffy freelancer?
Okay, number three is an interesting response. I am not going to turn in Phineas Wells. At least not yet. Alex is dead.
Oh no, this is terrible. My dear friend, what devilry is this? In whose miserable fever dream am I trapped?
I'm sorry for your loss.
Oh, Alex. There were so many arguments we'd yet to have.
What was your relationship with Alex?
He was my dearest friend. My only friend. You have his ship, you must know. That picture of us on the promenade, me hugging him, him wincing. I keep a copy beside my bed. Did he?
Yep, he sure did.
Ah, that's just like him. Such a sentimental man. Tell me, how did he die?
He died in an escape pod accident.
Oh, awful business that. But why? How? No. Best not to ask after the gory details.
Again, I'm very sorry. Can we get back to the topic at hand?
Right. You're going important places, I'm sure. Big, exciting, important places.
Maybe.
There, I've removed the flag from your ship.
Oh,
I'm
thanks.
Terribly sorry for the inconvenience. However, before you go...
However?
Alex promised to tell me the location of Phineas Wells. I'm sure you've seen his wanted posters all over the colony. Did Alex tell you where Wells might be? Anything at all?
Why is the board so interested in Wells, anyway?
You haven't read the posters? He's a terrorist, a thief, a madman. It's really in the colony's best interest that we stop him before he does further harm.
Well, I'm sorry. Alex never mentioned Phineas Wells.
That's... Well, that's just terrible news.
Wink.
Oh, what am I going to do now? The board will have my head. Oh, I'm sorry. This is terribly unprofessional of me. Is there anything else I might help you with?
I'm here about Jessie Doyle. I want her debt settled.
Miss Doyle owes the board a significant sum. Alas, the only collateral she has is her organs. Compulsory donation is quite legal in such cases.
Well, she'll point out that she is worth more alive than dead. Put her under an indenture contract.
That's not unreasonable.
I guess it's better than losing your organs, but... I don't know, Captain. It just doesn't seem right.
No.
Miss Doyle is deeply in debt, and the board has every right to do whatever they like to recoup that debt. What guarantee do I have that she'll agree to the terms you negotiate?
Well, maybe it was a bad idea, but... I don't want to shell out major bucks. I don't even know her. She's hiding in sickbay to avoid assassins. No, actually... I'm not give away her location. Way I see it, she doesn't have much choice.
I quite concur. It's refreshing to deal with someone practical for a change. I will recall my collection agent. Tell Miss Doyle to report to me promptly for her first assignment. Now, is there anything else you need, or can I return to my work?
I want to ask you something else.
Be my guest.
What do you do here exactly?
I'm the certified representative of the board's interests here on the Groundbreaker. I'm their eyes, ears, and busy little hands.
That doesn't answer my question.
I send a lot of messages. Sometimes I read them. Every once in a while, I'll impound a ship if I want to feel alive.
Does it seem hot in here to you?
Law, but it's miserable. My underarms are damp. How can I be expected to work in these conditions?
Chief Tennyson is supposedly looking into the cause, but I've seen no action from her. Deplorable conduct. My superiors will be hearing about it. You can be certain of that.
What are those locked doors in the back?
A luxury stateroom, reserved for Chairman Rockwell's use.
Does the chairman visit here often?
Oh, good law, of course not. He'd never set foot on this decrepit junk pile. As this office is the primary embassy for the board on Groundbreaker, corporate bylaws specifically state a room must be maintained for the chairman's exclusive use.
What are the armed guards for?
Oh, you've noticed my friends. Wonderful. Aren't their guns very large? Tremendously impressive.
I guess.
They're here to keep the peace, of course.
To watch your back, you mean?
Precisely. Groundbreaker makes much ado about its independent status and so resents any board presence, no matter how benign.
You call keeping officers on their promenade benign?
When the alternative is board guards at their gates, yes, I do. They don't see it that way, of course, but I can't say I much care.
Can you get me to Stellar Bay?
Good law! Who'd want to go to that toxic hell pit?
So, no?
No. Emphatically no. Unequivocally no. Immutably no.
No one would have done it. You didn't have to crack open the thesaurus.
Best to be clear, I believe. Ask away.
No one else seems to mind. Can I look at his passcode? Meaning it won't work, but... okay, never mind.
Have you seen this man? Reward offered for information leading to the capture of noted terrorists many times. Report any findings to your local board embassy. C&P chicken and potatoes. At C&P, we know our C&P.
And what's this again? Oh, yeah, the med bay. Oh, yeah.
Wish I could say it was good to see you, Ellie. At least you finally got your chance to square our debt. That ought to make you smile for once, huh?
Nothing makes me happier than being even. Except being right. That's nice, too.
Got word from Udom, from the hitman who trailed me the other night. Seems I'm indentured to the board now. I ain't too elated about going exclusive, but it's better than winding up dead.
Yeah.
You sure saved my skin, stranger. All debts between me and Ellie are cleared.
Nice, 1,000 bits. Watch yourself while I'm gone.
The good news came through the wireless. Looks like you paid my debt to Jessie. I guess that means I owe you now, right?
Oh, you do?
Tell you what, I'm a little short on bits at the moment, but I'm a decent scrapper and a better than average sawbones. If you're looking for a medic, I can work my debt off.
Are you saying you'll work for me just because I helped Jessie?
If I'm being honest, and I prefer not to, I was about ready to pick up another contract anyway, and you settled this in a pretty tidy fashion, which tells me you're competent. But we can say I'm repaying the favor if you prefer that version.
What exactly did Jessie do for you anyway? I've been wondering this.
She helped me win a bet.
What was the bet?
We were on a smuggling-run planet side when our point man bet me I couldn't outrun a mantisaur.
Don't tell me you tried.
What can I say? Something about people telling me I can't do a thing that just makes me itch to prove them wrong. And, as you can probably guess, the thing was faster than it looked. Probably would have caught me if Jessie hadn't picked it off.
So she saved your life.
Yeah, but the important thing is I won the bet.
You really don't like owing people, do you?
It's like people touching a cookie and leaving it in the box. It's just one of those things that gets under my skin.
Sure, welcome aboard, Ellie.
You won't be sorry. Though it looks like you've got a full roster already. Time to play favorites, Captain.
Vicar Max, I'll catch up with you on the ship later.
Dr. Fenhill, glad you opted to join us. It'll be good to have a Sawbones on the crew.
Whoa. And we leveled up yet again. So he's waiting for us back on the ship.
Something on your mind?
If we're going to work together, I'd like to know a bit more about you.
I'm a surgeon by training and a pirate by inclination.
A pirate?
Not much else to know, Captain. I like long walks on the promenade and the smell of Spacer's Corona. I make a mean zero-G cocktail and I've got a meaner right hook.
I'm going to play stupid and ask her what's a zero-G cocktail.
It's a mix of whatever you've got on hand. Usually zero-G brew with some Spectrum vodka if you're lucky. Purple berry shake if you're not.
So you never quite know what you're getting.
Exactly. That's what makes them fun.
Inventive. I like it.
I'll make you one sometime. If you don't enjoy it, I'll make a few more until you do.
Okay. Do you have much experience contracting out with other captains?
Sure do. Some of it was even legal.
You weren't joking about being a pirate, were you?
What gave it away? It's the hair, right? Or maybe the ammo belt? I had it custom made.
Oh. So, wait, you want to look like a pirate?
Gotta advertise your business somehow. I've done all types of work with all kinds of crews. If there's one thing you ought to know about me, it's that I won't tell you your business. Your ship, your way.
That sounds reasonable.
Glad to hear it. It's worked for me this long.
I was hoping to know something more personal about you.
Well, my blood type is AB positive. I'm a Leo, and I despise Space Hospital. Never mind what anyone else tries to tell you. That about covers it.
Where are you from, and how did you get into this line of work?
Aw, come on. That stuff's boring.
You're deflecting.
Look, the thing I've learned about living in close quarters is that you've got to give people room to breathe. I'm all for making a few bits together and having fun doing it, but let's keep a little professional distance.
All right, back to business.
No complaints here.
Okay, so... okay, so Parvati can level up. Oh, she has a perk available. Fine aim. Battle hardened. 5 armor rating. Increase the damage dealt by this companion dealing melee weapons. Extracting mods. Maximum health. Threat generated. Yeah, I don't want that. Imagine taking both of these, which would be very stupid, and just evening out. Increase your engineering skill when Parvati is in the party. Hey, let's do this. Okay. So now I have access to these things. Companion ability damage. Chance to reset ability cooldown, okay. And then Ellie has two perks available. I'm gonna decrease the threat on her as well. Plus 20% heal amount granted by the medical inhaler. Otherwise all the same stuff. Increase your medical skill when Ellie is in the party. Okay, good. Sounds good to me. Oh, and I can level myself up as well. It's always saying that. Alright, let's get defense up a little bit more. And then... dialogue. Oh, and, well, yeah. Accept, and then I've got perks. Or a perk. So once I get... I think 5 of these, then I can advance. Yeah, once I get, yeah, so the next time I'll be able to get a tier 2. But what would I like as far as out of this? Would alone in party, that's, I'm not really gonna be alone. Walk speed, sprint speed, better durability, companion crit chance, vendor prices, XP from companion kills. Fast traveling when encumbered. Tactical time dilation. Recharge rate. So right now I have carrying capacity. Additional ammo. Tactical dilation meter max. Yeah, I would like to use the tactical time dilation more. So we'll do that. Level 10. Nice. It looks like we've made quite a bit of into level 10 as well. What is down there? I guess death? Besides death. Oh, pardon me.
You ever hard up for work? Try sublight salvage. Good pay if you're morally flexible.
When might we expect you out here again? Canned surface is already sold out again.
Who knows? Halls are scarce. Back in Triangulum, there were hundreds.
Have I been up here?
Purple berry fudge, a soft sour candy shell around a sweet purple berry flavored center. Suck it, chew it, you can do it. Rizzo's purple berry crunch. Triple flake and purple berry flavored.
You don't pay your docking fees, your ship gets seized. I seen it happen.
Yeah, mine got seized for something else, but it's good now. There's more. Unless this is back. This is where I came from. So wait a minute. We would still want Jen Lee Tennyson, who's down here. I must have missed something because I did not find her.
Have you seen this man? Reward offers for information leading to the capture of noted terrorist Phineas. Report any sightings to your local warden.
How do I get back there? Oh, this opens. Okay. I haven't saved for a while. So. Oh my god, this place is huge!
This is those XF-411s? And an old Yakata 37? You think they'd let me peek at the power plant?
It's
spacers. I don't know.
Or is it hot in here? June Lay's got to be having a bad day.
Tuna production for this quarter's earning.
Bad few weeks. Well, she's right over there. Let's look around for a bit.
Party brave workers taken against their will to live outside of corporate security have at last come home to Edgewater. Great job, as always, to our hard-working cannery technicians. This has been Halcyon News, your only source for news in the Halcyon colony.
Well, isn't that convenient?
If something's broke, fill out an incident report. You keep the yellow copy.
I wouldn't know if anything was broken. Edna?
Good law, the heat in here is so unbearable, I can hardly even concentrate. June Lay better hurry up with those damn repairs already.
If it's not a life or death problem, I've got more important repairs.
Yeah, you look busy, so... Workbench.
I was fixing that toilet you sent me to repair. The one above the Lost Hope?
Private Taylor?
That was days ago. The fucking door, it locked behind me. And it wasn't until this raider captain found me that I...
You're lucky the chief would have my ass if I spaced you. Now get back to work, Private.
Right away, sir. Suppose it's time to reevaluate my career goals.
Perhaps.
Watch out, something doesn't explode in your face.
Yeah, I wouldn't prefer that. Sealed.
When I started this job, you could go days without a major incident. Now, it's just hours.
Sounds exciting, though, in an annoying way.
Careful where you point that thing.
What thing?
This is Halcyon News. We interrupt your regular... Reports from concerned supervisors indicate that rates of time theft are on the rise.
Time theft.
We urge all of our listeners to remember that lack of productivity is not a victimless crime. Workers should be on the lookout for slacking and underperformance. Report anyone you suspect of time theft to your supervisor immediately. You've been listening to Halcyon News. Your mandated duty as a good citizen...
Hotter than usual in here. Hope we're not catching June Lay on a bad day.
Probably aren't.
All day in here and not have looked at half the best stuff. It's all pretty worn, though.
Hello?
June Lay Tennyson. I'm captain around here, but chief to my friends. Hope you don't mind the formal introduction. Groundbreaker doesn't see many visitors.